gentlemen, is we have what, as close as what we'll ever get sometimes in our lives to creating magic. And when we're all together in a room like this, just feeling the love and the music, it's a special thing. And especially when we sing together. I mean, where do you go today where you can sing in such great amounts of volume? You can't. It's impressive. It's moving, and it will rock you right down to the center of your soul. That's why I do what I do. This next song is a song I wrote when I was 18. Whoa. And it's sort of developed into something more special for me now, because the story is that when I was about 17, I asked my mother if I could have the money that she and my father had put away for my education. Could I have the money for a piano? And she said, yes, you may. So I took $1,000 and I bought a piano. And for the summer of 1977, I drove everybody in my family out of the house with my terrible piano playing. I practiced and I practiced, and I came up with a song. And it's surprising to be able to sing it only a few years later, like this for you. But what I wanted to tell you is that I'm very grateful to my mother and father for the opportunity. Because my parents say, oh no, you have to go finish your education. No, I dropped out when I was 15, and this is my education. Look at where we are today. The special thing is that when I sing this song now, I dedicate it to my mother and father. My father passed away this year, and my mother also had a stroke, and now she's in a wheelchair. So, which leads me to my next story, which is about India. And when I was coming over here on the airplane, I noticed a young man looking after his father, which I understand is a very Indian thing, to have the family live together. And I said, oh, is this your father? And he goes, yes. He says, he's coming to live with me now. I said, oh, that's great. I said, my father was living with me at the end of his life also. He says, well, maybe you are a little bit Indian. I see you on the streets of Manhattan.
Thank you.